Hello, I'm Jeff Hannan, Eastern District Manager for Engineered Systems. And today we're at the Gorman-Rupp facility in Mansfield, Ohio, actually in the Engineered Systems demonstration area, where today we're going to be looking at our priming tower. It's one of the units that we have that we can run through some different scenarios from field applications and do some troubleshooting. Basically what we have for setup is we have a T3 pump, a 3-inch Super T-Series pump by Gorman-Rupp, mounted about 15 feet above a open tank of water. We've got a suction line that's got glass piping, and we've got some blue colored water so we can see the suction line is full right now. And also on the suction side, we've removed the suction flap valve, so we've got a straight end suction. There's no check valves on the suction side to hold the water. And then on the discharge side, our piping has no discharge check valve and no plug valve in the discharge line. We removed a section of pipe and installed a fire hose so that we can see how violently or quickly the water fills that hose when we're looking at the different types of starters that we're using today. Then our discharge line comes back down to the tank, and I've got three different areas that I can pump the water. I can let the water recirculate back to the tank. I can pump the water through the wall to a separate holding area so I can lower the level in the tank. And then I've also got a discharge line that allows me to discharge directly onto the suction inlet of our suction line. We're using a 15 horsepower motor with our pump, and we're running at about 1650 RPM pump speed for most of the demonstration. The first scenario we want to look at is using the across the line starter to run the pump. Again, this is going to be a full on and a full off situation. So what I want to do is from the control panel here, I'm just going to run through a couple of cycles of start and stop, and we're going to keep our eye on that discharge hose and see how quickly the fire hose fills with water and with a certain amount of violence or force that it does fill that line. Again, this is a 3-inch pump with a 15 horsepower motor, not a large amount of horsepower or a large amount of flow that we're talking about, and you just see how much water hammer or shock that we can put into the system here. So we'll run through a couple of cycles. But again, if you're in a situation where you're pumping water up a high hill or in a high head application, probably been in a pump station where you're pushing the water up the hill, you shut the pump off, the water starts rushing back to the pump station, check valves start slamming, header piping starts moving around. And again, this is only a 15 horsepower application that we're looking at right here. So there's no control with an across line starter. It's full on, full off. You take what you get, and sometimes that causes a lot of issues with header piping and check valve slamming and things of that nature. So what we'll do now is I'll switch over to the soft starter, or the reduced voltage solid state starter in the middle here. And this one now allows us to have some ramp time on the start and on the stop. And we'll do the same scenario. We'll run through a couple of cycles here, and we're going to again watch the fire hose and just see what kind of force we're looking at. This should slow that down quite a bit, fill the hose a little bit slower, and we'll run through a couple of cycles now to demonstrate that. You can hear the pump starting to ramp up. And then bring it back down as it ramps back down. Go through another cycle. Now just by adding this soft starter, we've eliminated a lot of that violence, a lot of that hammer action in the fire hose. And it's a nice thing about the soft starter too. You can see physically it's about the same size as the across the line starter, so it doesn't take up that much additional panel space. Costs have come down on those to make them a nice option for pump stations. So if you're in a situation where a water hammer could be an issue, or you want to control the starting and stopping of the flow of the liquid in the discharge, that can be a nice option for you. The last one that we want to look at now is, of course, the variable frequency drive. And again, this is going to give you a more of an infinite control. There's only limits on the start time and the stop time on the soft starter. But again, it basically runs at full voltage when it's up to speed. The variable frequency drive can run at any speed between 0 and 60 hertz that you want it to operate. So on this one, we've got it set up for a little bit slower ramp time even than the soft starter. And again, we'll watch the fire hose just to give you an idea of how much control we can have over the flow of the liquid. And now hit the stop and bring it back down to off position. And we'll ramp it back down much slower than even the soft starter did before. And then one more time on the start, just to see how slowly it does fill the fire hose. And then bring it back down on the stop. Many times a variable frequency drive is used to control flow or to match wet well levels in a sewage wet well. But in certain cases, it may be necessary to use the variable frequency drive where we have high head applications or situations where water hammer is present at a pump station and we want to have more control over the liquid as it leaves the pump station. Okay, so you can see from looking at the three different types of starters, again, an across the line starter is going to be full on, full off, no real control over the flow. The soft starter, reduced voltage solid state starter, again gives you a on ramp and an off ramp that can help control a little bit with water hammer. And then the variable frequency drive, which gives you the most control going from 0 hertz to 60 hertz or from stop to full speed. And that concludes this portion of our demonstration today.
For more information on pump hydraulics, equipment, or application engineering, watch Gorman-Rupp's YouTube channel and visit us at grpumps.com.